She wasn't hurting my baby?
Leave me alone. I'm asking no questions. I already know.
Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel, and if you are new, welcome, and don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share this video with everybody. Okay you guys, so today we are getting ready to go over Monica's house and getting her new pool. I'm excited. It's a little hot right now, so I did tell her that I will come over there closer to like 5:36, and it's now almost 4 o'clock, so I gotta get ready to go. I'm trying to figure out what I'm gonna put my swimsuit in. I might put it in one like my little book bags. Maybe my Dolce & Gabbana or my Donna Karan. Like, I think I may use my DKNY book bag because it's small and I can just throw my swimsuit in there. I'm trying to think what else I need. I think everything else should probably have at her house. But yeah. So we're getting ready to go over Monica's house. Y'all, today has just been really chill. Really just a really chill day. I cleaned up. I did my makeup in this mirror right here earlier because I was watching this show. I'm just wearing this cute little jumpsuit. It's like see-through kind of tank top. I think I got this tank top from, I want to say I got it from Forever 21. I can't remember. It was so long ago. I got it like a few years ago. Gotta get ready to go over Monica's house, and then I'll probably just see you guys when I get over there. Or actually, I'll probably talk to you guys when I get there. So I'm getting ready to go. I'm eating these Famous Amos cookies. Shout out to Famous Amos because these cookies are so old and everybody still enjoys them. I always get the ones with like the pecans in them. Well, bomb. So y'all know I'm still on portion control. So I'm gonna put me some in this little baggie because you guys are not using these little clamps for like your potato chips and your cookies and things that don't really have a seal, and you are missing out. These little clamp things keep everything fresh, like, and you have to get the hefty ones. I think I got this one. It's a little magnet too. I got this one, I think, from Bed Bath & Beyond, but go ahead and spend that little $5 on it, because when I tell you guys, it keeps everything so fresh for so long. So if you haven't been using these, missing out. Oh, and you guys, these have been my jam. These gel from Dole. This is the mandarin and orange flavored gel. You guys, when I tell you, for a healthy snack when you get hungry at night, I'm actually about to go ahead and grab me one now. I don't know how it gets you full. How many calories? You guys, 4 servings per container. The serving size is 1 cup. Y'all, is 100 calories. How is that possible? Well, maybe they're not gonna be like bad calories. Is there such thing as good calories and bad calories? I don't know, but these are good. I'm on my way to Monica's house still. It was supposed to take me longer than it did, so I'm kind of happy about that. Oh, she has a TJ Maxx by her house. We should go. Oh, and she has a Culver's. Oh, I forgot to tell you guys, remember that day I went to Culver's? Their shrimp was not that good. And I think I may have gotten a burger too one time, and the burger was burnt, like to a crisp burn. You accidentally just burnt it and just left it. Y'all, that's never happened at Culver's, but those two incidents are my only two bad experiences at Culver's. But I'm never getting their jumbo shrimp anymore because they were not that good. I meant to tell you guys that on that vlog, but I never turned my camera back on once I got home. But just so you guys know, I mean, you can try them yourself, but I didn't like their jumbo shrimp. I didn't feel like they were that good, so I thought I'd tell you guys. I've been living my best life. I love living in a state where it's just always hot. It's nice and sunny because, as you guys know, I'm from Chicago, and that is not the case there. Honey, when I tell you, it gets gloomy, it gets snowy, it gets cold and windy. No. So I think I'm really, I don't what God has planned for me, but I can definitely tell you guys, if it's up to me, where I live now is where I want to raise my family. Like, I think this is an excellent environment. They'll get a chance to, my kids will be able to ride their bikes 365 and play outside 365 and just be in a good mood. Because as you guys know, like, when the weather is nice, for like, you know, like, you feel good. So that's kind of the type of life I want for my kids. I want to be able to, like, to raise happy children and for everybody to be happy. Like, me and my husband could be outside barbecuing, having picnics and things like that. Like, that's the type of life I'm trying to live. Listen, I was gonna try Smoothie King. I should try Smoothie King really quick. Actually, you guys, I think I'm going to do that. I've never had Smoothie King before. I'm about to turn around. I'm not that far from Monica's house, but I really want to try Smoothie King. So let me grab me a smoothie really quick. I had to make me a quick Yui. And I'm really not a big smoothie person, so I don't even know what kind of smoothie. When you think of a smoothie, I'm trying to think. I'm not a smoothie person. I'm a shake person. And I'm a frosty person. But I don't really know much about smoothies. Oh, this little area over here is cute. All right, how do I get in here? That's what I'm trying to figure out. What type of smoothies? I've never had Smoothie King. But I'm about to grab me a smoothie today. Yeah, I was thinking about going in the inside so I can taste them. See what Smoothie King. Actually, let me look at my phone to see what smoothies are good at Smoothie King. Hold on, y'all. Okay, you guys. Why is this so dark? Okay, you guys. So I just tried the pineapple and strawberry smoothie. It was like Make It Slim or something like that. So we shall see. I didn't know you could add fruit to the smoothies. I should have added some. After I got finished ordering, I was like, oh, I should have added some bananas or mangoes. I got a medium. I want to see how this tastes. It's essentially just fruit. Y'all, I really want to go on a vegetable diet. Like, I was reading Daniel in the Bible today, and it was talking about how he went on his vegetable diet, like vegetable and water diet, and how they looked more healthier. It said they looked more healthier and something else. But I was like, ooh, I need to go on a Daniel fast.
Hi.
Hi.
The guy in front of you actually paid for your order.
Shut up.
Yeah, he was really nice.
That is God. Y'all hear that? Oh,
there you go.
Gosh.
So he'll be out in just a moment. You don't have to worry.
Thank you.
No problem.
Does he come here often?
Yeah, I've seen him a few times.
I feel like I want to pay for his the next time he comes. Is that possible?
Because
you guys wouldn't know what he gets. Yeah. Oh, I love that. Oh my gosh. That is so awesome. Did you guys hear that? I'm happy I turned on my camera to show you guys, because I do that for people all the time. I pay for the person in front of me.
You are?
Thank you.
That's a medium.
Look at the medium. Thank you.
Have a great day.
You too. Look at the medium, you guys. Oh my gosh. You guys. That was so awesome. All right, you guys. I'm getting ready to try this smoothie. Oh, this is good. Y'all, that feeling after somebody pays for you and you don't really know. Sorry, y'all, that's a bump. That's a speed bump. And you don't really know who they are. Oh my gosh. Like, you can't thank them. That feeling is just like, it leaves you kind of incomplete. But I get it, because typically when you do that, you kind of want to hurry up and leave. You know, it's like a surprise. Oh my gosh, God is so good. Oh my gosh, that just warmed my heart. Even though I could have paid for it myself, I just That just, it just lets me know that God is thinking about me. That is sweet, because all good things come from him. The fact that he put me on somebody else's mind, oh my gosh, I'm about to cry. That was so sweet. That was just so sweet.
Why
am I
hungry?
Why aren't you hungry?
Put your dress down. Oh, my horse, you back. Yeah, come on. Yeah, you gotta make sure you got a hold it tight because if I drop for your dad, your mom is not gonna forgive you. So, hey, you two, hi, you two, cheers. You have so many cute little like cute restaurants over here. We do, but you ever go? That's what I was wondering. Like, no. You don't like a lot of cheese. Tell you guys, Monica doesn't like anything that has to do with any flavor. She wants everything to have its original flavor. She doesn't eat condiments like ketchup, you know, barbecue sauce. Like, I know I go crazy about my barbecue sauce. I'm not her. Look what Monica doing, y'all. She's cutting me up some food. That's my love. This is a mom.
So I am over Monica's house. I'm about to go in the, I'm in the guest room and I'm getting ready to put on my bathing suit, but I wanted to take you guys with me. I think they're getting ready to paint, so don't mind that. I want my bathing suit in this, like, my little bag. Let me,
you guys, this is my bathing suit. Anyway. Exactly. Yeah, we are enjoying ourselves at the pool. It's such a nice day out here.
Yeah, I got my hair wet.
It's okay. If you are new, welcome, and don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share this video with everybody. Y'all see I have another one of my scarves on. Let me stitch y'all down because, okay, you guys, so today has been so weird. I plugged my TV up to watch it and I didn't even watch it. I woke up super early this morning like I always do, but now that things are open, I think I'm still trying to adjust. No, I just like lately I just been feeling like ever since we opened back up, still kind of feel like it's still shut down because we were locked down for so long. Y'all, I'm scarred. I was locked down for too long. Like, I wasn't used to being in the house like that. I'm like, I'm a homebody anyway. I want a cheese, a Philly cheesesteak. So I think I'm gonna go to the mall and get that. That's all I'm going to the mall for because I'm really not looking to shop like that for real. I really don't feel like doing anything. I have to get an outfit for Shalyn's wedding though. Shalyn's wedding is coming up very, very soon. So I really need to start. I kind of have an idea what I'm going to wear, but I probably could go see if I could find something for her wedding. I'm really not in a mood to shop today, so I might not do that today. Maybe I'll do that tomorrow. But for sure, we're gonna go to Charlie's today. Ooh, you guys, so I don't like scary movies like that because I'm really not like, I'm not really one to cause fear on myself, if that makes sense. Like, I used to love, love, love scary movies. I do wanna see A Quiet Place. Is that it? A Quiet Place 2 or something like that? That's coming out soon. I wanna see that movie so bad. I was thinking, like, I really wish, so I've been trying to eat good, but I feel like I need somebody to help me, if that makes sense. Like, I don't really know where to start when it comes to like eating healthy. Like really eating healthy. The thing about me is I want to eat healthy, but I feel like the healthy things don't taste as good as the bad things, if that makes sense. I know it probably sounds terrible, but That's just really how I feel. Like, I don't feel like I eat terribly bad, but I'm also not making the best choices. Like, we'll see. My future is really bright on YouTube and I know it. Like, I could just tell, right? Like, I'm not like everybody, you know, and I'm blessed. So I know for sure, like, my channel is gonna go up. I understand why people have editors and people to edit their videos, because it's a tedious process. But I feel like, this is just kind of my mindset because I'm a beginner, but I don't know, for some reason I feel like it will be so weird. It kind of takes the creativity out, but then you're also employing somebody else, which is a good thing, and you're also getting their perspective, opposed to just having your own when you edit, because what's good to you is not, you know what I'm saying? Like, you could obviously do better sometimes because if you had like somebody else's advice. So it is good to take people's advice, but I literally was thinking, like, I will have to be a part of that process. Like, the entire, I don't know, I will feel like I will want to be right there by the editor, like,
no, keep that, no, erase that.
I might be a very picky creator when it comes to, like, working with my editor, so I don't know. And then again, I might just have a good, like, I might just love my editor. I was just thinking ahead, you know, so, and I've been looking up just different things, you know. I feel like it's always important to have your end goal in mind. So I've been trying to think of different things, like, you know, different avenues with YouTube, like events in my mind, because if I don't see myself there already, then it's kind of hard for you to get there, right? If you don't already see it, like vision, like tunnel vision. So yeah, I don't know what that has to do with anything, but I just wanted to share that with you guys. So, all right, y'all, let's go before it gets dark. Y'all, I still haven't tested my night vision. I need to test my night vision out. I'm a day girl. Like, when I tell y'all, I don't really do much at night. Like, I'm like a day, whatever you call those day people. I know night is like nocturnal, but I forgot what you call the day people. But that's me. Like, I wake up super early. I'd rather get my day started early. And then, like, typically around 10 o'clock and 9:30, it's time to go to sleep. So I don't really hang out at night. She got that from her TV.
Yeah, she got the English.
No, she got that from me.
I just already washed her hair. I got her hair appointment set up for when she come down there. I gotta get it braided.
That girl gonna do it?
Yeah, probably gonna do it. I just took her braid out today. I'm about to have, I actually have Liliana, this little girl, that they can take her braid down. I'll give her a $5.
She wasn't her and my baby?
Leave me alone. I'm asking no questions. I already know.
We are on our way. Philly cheesesteak. I typically get the chicken Philly cheesesteak, but I think today I'm feeling a little spontaneous. I think I'm gonna get an actual Philly cheesesteak. I don't know, I'm feeling a little different. I'm feeling a little spicy. May add some little extra stuff on it. Wait a minute, it's 7 o'clock. Don't the mall close at 7? Bro. I pray to God this mall is not closed. Look how light it is outside. 7 o'clock. They better not close at 7 o'clock. I'm going to be so... Oh, they close at 9. I was about to say. It was about to be a problem, okay? Because... So, we have about 2 hours. So... Y'all see I don't have any nails on or anything. I hope y'all don't be talking about me. Do y'all be talking about me when I don't be dressed as cute? No, y'all don't be talking. If you are new, welcome, and don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share this video with everybody. I'm on my way to do some personal stuff right now, but we have a day planned for us. We are out here in this beautiful sun, so we have plans today. We have some things to get into, and I'm excited. I'm ready to get into them. I really just only have this jacket on because of my meeting, but this needs to come off, and I may even just change my entire outfit later on. So did want to get on here because I just got dressed. I didn't want to forget to say my little intro once we started to move around. I know for sure I have to go get my toes done today. I'm going to get my nose shot one more time, okay, to do right by me because I don't have time. Hopefully they're not busy today and then I can get my toes done and I'll be happy because that'll be one thing off my list that I have to do. I think after that, we'll see. As you guys know, like my life is not like, things don't really happen in like order. So sometimes it's tough for me to give you guys an agenda, but yeah. So y'all, my sister Gray had surgery yesterday. I have to FaceTime her to see how she's doing. Y'all saw my last vlog where me and my baby sister was messing with her. She looks like she just had a BBL. So that's one thing about us. Like when me and my younger sister, Nisha, Lyra's mom, when we get together, like all we do is crack jokes and everything is always so funny. And we're always messing with my middle sister, Gray, because she's more of the serious one. She's really not, like she doesn't, like she's really not into all the jokes and stuff like that. So we're always messing with her. Joys of having sisters. So, and then when we all three get together and my mom is around, we mess with her. We gang up on her. So, in a fun way, but mess with my mom. It's gonna be so funny because once the baby, I call my niece Lyra, if you guys haven't noticed, I call her the baby because my mom only has one grandchild right now. My baby sister is the only one out of us three that has a child. So, essentially, she is the baby because, there's no other baby in our like immediate family, but you guys will hear me refer to her as the baby. But anyway, like I was getting ready to say, it's going to be so funny because once the baby gets older, she's gonna be able to like do the same thing, so she'll be the extra person to gang up. We're trying to see whose side she's gonna be on. Either she's gonna be with us or she's probably gonna be with my mom because she loves her granny. I really need to go back home and see them. I may fly home for like a day or something, maybe like a day or two, because so I can see the baby because I haven't seen her. She's coming out here. Actually, I still have to go home though for, I got some stuff I need to do at home anyway. Guys, Mother's Day is coming up. Mother's Day is coming up. I have no clue what I'm going to get my mom. And I'm like this every single year. Like, I don't really know what I want to get her. I had looked at this company that, like, makes flowers. They do, like, the long stem flowers. But they're out here. So, I don't know if they deliver. Maybe I'll stop by there to see what they're talking about. Because I think they're close to where I'm getting ready to go. I may just give her some long stem flowers. And then they, like, wrap them in these cute little, like, see-through bows. Like a vase, but it's out of, like a scarf material. So I may just do that. I also shipped her. She wanted, I don't know if you guys have ever paid attention, but when I'm cooking with you guys, like I use like that salt and pepper that's electric. I actually got those from Walmart, you guys. So if anybody is curious, if anybody likes those, you get them from Walmart. Just put batteries in them and then like you can press the button on top and your salt and pepper just kind of like comes out and there's a light right at the bottom where you can like see where it's going around your food. So yeah, so I got those from Walmart. So I don't think they're at the Walmart in Illinois, and they may have them or they may not have them, but in your city, but I'm pretty sure you guys could order them. They're on Walmart, they're at Walmart. I don't know the brand though, I forgot the brand name, but I did ship her a salt and pepper one like that. And she should be getting that, I think, Monday. She'll be happy about that because she's been asking me about them. It's like, but that's really not even a Mother's Day gift. I just picked it up because I was out of town and I saw them. So, I don't know what I'm going to get her. Comment below some Mother's Day ideas. She's a little picky, though. Like, my mom, comment below if your mom is like this. Like, my mom is a little picky when it comes to gifts. And sometimes, I'm not going to lie, like, it irritates me a little bit because it's like, you know, it's just kind of like, mom, like, just be grateful. I be trying to get like little small stuff. She be like, nuh-uh. I want a Louis Vuitton purse. I want this and that. So, yeah, she's a little feisty. Okay, you guys, I'm just kind of rambling. I will see you guys in a minute once I get through with this. Here at Wendy's, I'm getting ready to get me something to eat. And then I'm getting ready to go to my old nail spot because since my new spot, I'm on this side of town anyway. So I'm just getting ready to go over here and get my nails done. Is it just me, but when you're getting ready to go to a higher level in life, like when God's like bringing you up, you're not really fearful by it. But I feel like it's just so, like, it's a weird feeling, uncomfortable because it's new, but it's also extremely exciting. Like, I'm so excited. Do I need to pull up to the second window? Or is somebody gonna come to the first window? I need y'all to come to the first window and tell me to move up. Don't signal me at the second window. Like, what if I didn't see? They should have a sign. They gotta do better. But the reason why I came here. Can I have a straw?
A straw? Yeah.
So, alright. So we have our food. I have my payment stuff. So now we're getting ready to go, y'all. We gotta go get our toast done. Are they coming out? What y'all doing? All right. Cause I ain't got time to let them. And these parking spots are pretty big. That's exactly what I needed. All right, come on, y'all. Let's go. Something held me, led me to you.